Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Today is December the 6th, and we're going to go ahead on and get started with our devotional service, and then we will have one of our ministers come and deliver the word. And we pray that you have a heart to receive what thus says the Lord. We're going to open with hymn number 99. Guide me, O thy great Jehovah, pilgrim through this barren land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Guide me.
Bird. have mercy,
mercy
on my soul.
Yes.
Father God, is once again,
yes.
this the humble servant have bowed down to pray to you one more time.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Praying to you, dear Master, for you are my Father.
Yes.
You are the one who made it.
Yes, Lord.
And you are the one who sustained this, thy body.
Yeah.
And Father God, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Father God, you are a mighty, mighty good God.
Yes, you are.
Father God, you have been better to each one of us than we have been to ourselves.
Yes, yes, yes.
Father God, because you are the one who watched over us all night last night while we slumber and slept.
Yes.
And dear Master, you didn't think it to be robbery. But you touched us once again with a finger of love and awakened us once again to see a day that we had never seen before.
Yes,
and Father God, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
You are a mighty, mighty good God.
Yes.
You are the God, the Master who sits high.
Yes.
And you are the one who looks low.
Yes.
You are the one who takes care of our every being.
Yes.
And Father God, we just want to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Father God, as we come this morning, we come this morning asking you that thou would just have mercy.
Mercy.
Have mercy upon each one of us, dear Master.
Yes.
Father God, because we cannot do anything without you.
Nothing.
We cannot sing, dear Master. We cannot pray, dear Master. We cannot even bring your word, dear Master, for you are the one who take care of our every being.
Yes,
and Father God, we just ask thee that thou would just have mercy.
Yes,
Father God, we just want to ask thee that thou would just bless each one who's bowed down on my weak voice this morning. Father God, because we need you, dear Master.
Yes,
Father God, we need you, dear Master, in these times of the pandemic, and Father God, we just ask thee that thou would just have mercy.
Yeah.
We know, dear Master, that you can remove it anytime you so desire.
Yeah.
And Father God, we just ask thee that thou would just have mercy.
Yeah.
And dear Master, we just ask thee that thou would just bless the state of the United States of America.
Mm-hmm.
Father God, we need you, dear Master.
Yeah.
Father God, mankind is trying to put things in his own way.
Mm-hmm.
But Father God, we know that you are the one who can take care of it, dear Master.
Yeah.
And Father God, we just ask thee that thou would just have mercy.
Yeah.
Father God, we do pray for the Shiloh Baptist Church this morning.
Yeah.
Father God, we pray that for our pastor.
Yeah.
Pray that Master for his membership.
Yeah.
Father God, we just ask thee that thou would just bless each one who may stand in need of a blessing. Father God, because we all need you, dear Master. We can't do anything without you. Father God, we do pray for the priest person who's coming this morning. Father God, we realize that you've already given her a word. Father God, we just ask thee that thou would just help us to be receiver of your word. After receiving your word, dear Master, we pray that thou would just help each one of us to go out and tell dying men and women, boys and girls, that the wages of sin is still death. But the gift of God is eternal life. Father God, we just ask you that thou would just have mercy. Then the Master, when we finish praying down here on this earth, can't pray any more down here, the Master. We pray that thou would remember each one of us and give us a home somewhere in your kingdom where we can praise your name forever and ever.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Glory to God in the highest.
Amen.
Amen. He is most worthy to be praised.
Yes, yes.
Amen. We continue to lift our voices to God by singing hymn number 93. Oh, come all ye faithful. Amen. He deserves our faithfulness. Our faithful God deserves our faithfulness. We call him our Father. And we are his children. And he deserves our faithfulness. Amen. Amen. So we invite all who profess that Jesus Christ is Savior to lift up their voices. Amen. Oh, come all ye joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him. for him, Christ the Lord. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Amen. He is most worthy to be praised. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
Amen. Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Amen. Thank God for this another day. And we certainly thank God for including us in this day.
Thank you,
God.
Thank you.
Amen. Let us go before the throne of grace. Eternal God, our Father.
Yeah.
God, we come, O God, unto you, yeah. Our Father, our sovereign God,
yeah.
Our creator, Lord God, our sustainer. We come, O God, as empty pitchers, O God, needing to be filled, God. Fill us up, O God, fill us up. Strengthen us by your word, O God. Help us, O God, that we may honor you in all that we say and do. God, we pray that you will get our attention, O God, through your word, by your Holy Spirit. We pray, O God, that if sin dwells within, that we repent of it, oh God. We pray that the Holy Spirit will convict our hearts, oh God, that we will confess our sins and repent that we may be forgiven, oh God, that we may serve you with all readiness of heart. We just bless your name, God, because we cannot thank you enough, oh God, and our desire is to please you because you are most worthy to be praised. Oh God, and the best way we can please you is to operate in obedience. Oh God, that our lives and that what we say, oh God, will, oh God, seek to save those that are lost. We bless your name, oh God. We thank you, God. Have your perfect way. Oh God, strengthen me where I'm weak and build me up where I'm torn down. Help us all, oh God. Help us all, oh God, where we stand weak, oh God. Strengthen us as only you can. And we will be so careful to give you all the praise, all the glory, God, all the honor, oh God, because it is due unto you. It is in Jesus' name we pray and thank you, God. Amen. Amen, God, amen. Thank you, God. As we have been led by the Holy Spirit, we share with you this morning from Psalm 51, a very familiar scripture, amen. A very familiar scripture, amen. But oh God, we thank you, God, because your word throughout is timeless, oh God.
Amen.
It's always on time, God.
Yes,
and we just thank you, oh God, for an opportunity to revisit your word, oh God.
Yes.
Thank you. Psalm 51, have mercy upon me, oh God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Amen. Thank you, God.
Amen.
Oh, God, we need you, God.
Yes.
David asked God to wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee, thee only, have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, David cries, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Hide thy face from my sins and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Verse 13, David says, then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation. And my tongue shall sing aloud of thy righteousness. Amen. Sing aloud. Hallelujah. Aloud. Amen. Tell the world. Amen. How good God has been to you. Oh Lord, David says, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise. For thou desirest not sacrifice, else would I give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God. Thou wilt not despise. Do good in thy good pleasure unto Zion. Build thou the walls of Jerusalem. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifices of righteousness, with burnt offering and whole burnt offering. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. Amen. We got to get our hearts right. Amen. Then, that's when the then comes in. Amen. Praise God. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Amen. As we have been led by the Holy Spirit, amen, we share with you this morning the awakened sinner. The awakened sinner. Hallelujah. Amen. David was a shepherd boy who became the second king of Israel. And Nathan served as a prophet, amen, in Israel during the reigns of David and of his son Solomon. Scripture records several occasions in which David and Nathan interacted. David and Nathan first meet regarding David's desire to build the temple of the Lord. But you know, and Nathan encouraged David to go on and build the temple, amen, that he desired for the Lord. Because David had a heart for God, amen. And David looked at where he was and where the ark of the Lord was. And he wanted to build a temple for God, amen. But God spoke and said that David had too much blood on his hand. That David would not go back and tell David that he would not be the one, amen, to build the temple. Amen. But he would raise up a seed, amen, and that seed would be Solomon. Solomon would be the one to build the temple. Amen. So Nathan is right there, amen, ministering as God would have him to do to David and then to Solomon. Amen. And then Nathan confronts David. We give you a little background, amen, to this awakened sinner. Amen. Nathan confronts David regarding a relationship, an ill-gotten relationship, a sinful relationship, because David, amen, David, King David, amen, was relaxing, amen. He was relaxing one day on his balcony, amen, when he should have been at war, amen, with his men. He was relaxing, amen. I'm going ahead and tell you now, you can relax too much. You can relax too much. Relaxing too much can get you into serious trouble, amen. So there is a danger in relaxing too much. David, while relaxing on the balcony, observed this beautiful woman, amen. And amen, he inquired as to who she was. She caught his eye. Her name was Bathsheba, amen. And she was the wife of Uriah the Hittite, amen. And David knows who she is, amen. But he still sins for, amen, Bathsheba. And he lies with Bathsheba, amen. So he is now sinning against God. He has given in to his flesh. There's a danger in relaxing too much, amen. I tell you right now, it can be detrimental to your family when the father relaxes too much, amen. The children can go astray when the mother relaxes too much, amen. Daughters can mess up real good, amen, in their walk and in their talk and in their behaviors, amen. You can't relax too much. Preachers can relax too much and don't study the word as they ought and end up not rightly dividing the word of God. You can't relax too much, amen. Even in the physical, we know when we have relaxed too much. Because sometimes we'll say, I don't know why I'm so sleepy. I've been laying around all day. I've been sleeping all day. I don't know why I'm here. I don't know why I'm there. Amen. Because we have given in too much to the flesh. We got to spend more time with God. Amen. So David finds himself, amen, in this position where he has given over himself to his flesh. Mm-hmm. And he sleeps with Uriah's wife. Mm-hmm. And she becomes pregnant. Amen. Amen. And David, instead of David confessing what he has done, David hides. Yeah, he tries to hide his sin. Amen. Committing one sin after another, amen. He even, amen, sins for Uriah off of the war line, amen, from the battlefield, amen, calling him home, amen, to get him to sleep with his wife, amen, because now she's pregnant, amen, but who's the baby's daddy? It is not the husband, amen. David recognizes that he has fathered a child with a married woman, a woman that belongs to another. So here he goes trying to cover up his sin, amen. And so he sins for Uriah, amen. But Uriah was an honorable man, and he was a true warrior, amen. And Uriah just couldn't conceive it in his mind to sit home and relax and lay down with his wife while his brothers were at war, amen, while his brothers were on the battlefield. So Uriah does not fall into David's scheme, amen. He does not fall to David's scheme, amen. And so he goes back, amen, to the battlefield, amen. And David, though, David still caught up in this world of sin. I tell you, sin will mess you up, amen. Amen, he is sinking so low in that he puts Uriah on the front line. Yes, he does. He gives orders that Uriah be placed on the front line in the war. Amen. That he may be killed, and that is just what happened. Yeah. Amen. As a result of his sins. Amen. David's sin. God who sits high and God who looks low. Amen. Amen. Says that David has gone too far. David needs to be confronted with his sins. Amen. He needs to see himself in the mirror of my word. And so God sends Nathan. Amen. He sends Nathan to confront David regarding his relationship with Bathsheba and the cover-up of their affair. The Lord had commanded Nathan to share a story of a rich man over in 2 Samuel, the 12th chapter. A rich man who took and killed a poor man's only lamb. David was justifiably angry. At the injustice. Nathan then answered, "Thou art the man." Look at you. You so upset, about this story. What about your life? What about the dirt you've done? You sent a man to die. Not just a lamb, but a man. You sacrificed a man's life because of your sin. My, David had blood on his hands. He was guilty of killing Bathsheba's husband as well as committing adultery. God brought judgment upon David for his sin, including the death of his and Bathsheba's child. However, David repented and was forgiven, and he remained king. Amen. But we do know that there are consequences. There are consequences, to committing sin. Actions have consequences. Nathan the prophet, was a blessing to King David. He was a close and trusted friend, He spoke the truth to David. That's the kind of friend you want, The one that's going to speak the truth, whether you like it or not. Because the truth is what's going to set us free, So he spoke word. And so Nathan confronts David. Amen. And then Nathan tells David, amen, he outlines three judgments as a result of David's sin. Now, we told you that actions have consequences, amen?
Yes, yes,
and so the word says in 2 Samuel chapter 12, verses 10 through 14, we're talking about the awakened sinner. Mm-hmm. Nathan says, now therefore, the sword will never depart from your house, because you despised me and took the wife of Uriah the Hittite to be your own. This is what the Lord says. Out of your own household, I am going to bring calamity on you. Mm-hmm. Before your very eyes, I will take your wives and give them to one who is close to you. Mm-hmm. And he will sleep with your wives in broad daylight. Mm-hmm. You did it in secret. Mm-hmm. But I will do this thing in broad daylight before all Israel. Why? You're the king.
Yeah.
The king ought to set the example.
That's right.
Amen. The Lord has taken away your sin, he says. You are not going to die. But because by doing this, you have shown utter contempt for the Lord, the son born to you will die. Mm-hmm. Our sin, my brothers and my sisters, shows utter contempt for the Lord. Look at God. Thank you, God. Now, God, who is merciful, the word says his mercy endureth forever. Uh-huh. Hallelujah. Amen. The word says we are blessed with his mercies, new mercies, every day.
Yeah.
Amen. And so because of God's great mercy, though David sinned and though we have sinned, Psalm 103 and 10 says, he does not treat us as our sins deserve, or repay us according to our iniquities. Now that's a hallelujah right there.
Hallelujah.
That's a thank you God right there. God don't treat us as our sins deserve.
Yeah.
Now, you know, some people will treat you, they'll get you just like you got them, amen?
Yeah.
But God is not like man.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. Thank you, God. He don't treat us as our sins deserve or repay us according to our iniquity. Because we know that the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. I'm so glad that the scripture didn't stop at the wages of sin is death. I'm glad it didn't stop right there.
Amen.
But the gift of God is eternal life. It doesn't even stop right there. Through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus paid the sin debt. And I thank you, God. Amen. Lamentations 3:22. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. Thank you, God. His great love for us. He loves us in spite of our sins.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, God. Amen. Born into sin, that's what David said, shaping into iniquity. But God loves us still. Amen. Loves us enough not to leave us right there in our sin, but made a way for us a long time ago when he gave his only begotten son, and his son laid down his life that we might be reconciled back to God. We serve an awesome God. Thank you, God.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
An awesome God. That's why David cries out, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness. Look at that compound word. Your loving kindness. Amen. Loving kindness. That's love. That's beyond love. We need your great love, and I need your compassion, God. I need your pity, God. Because I'm in a poor state. This sin has me in a poor state, God. So I need you to have mercy upon me, oh God. See, the sight of mercy, amen, when we can see God's mercy upon our lives, oh God, it's a blessing to a repentant sinner's heart. Mm-hmm. God's mercy let me see another day. God's mercy gave me another opportunity, amen, to confess my sin and be forgiven, amen. God's great mercy and his love and kindness toward us. He says, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercy. That mercy is beyond mercy. Multitude. Multitude of thy tender mercies. He says, let me, Lord, be the object of thine infinite mercy. And, oh God, repeat, make my case. Be an example of your great mercy. And in the psalm of my life, let it display your great mercy upon me. Oh, thank you, God. We need the Lord's mercy. David goes on to ask God to blot out my transgression, my revolt. Anything that, anytime we went opposite of what God said, we revolt. We rebelled. Amen. We indulge. And these acts are recorded against us. That's why David says, blot out my transgression. I know you got a record of it. Y'all know about that white out. When you make a mistake, you got a little pen or a little strip, you can white out the mistake and write over it, amen. This is sin. David is full of sin at this moment. And he asked God to blot out my transgression. I need God to blot out my transgression. They obliterate the record. Amen. I need it, whatever it takes, God.
Yeah.
I need you to erase.
Erase.
Erase. I don't even want them to look at what the way I spelt that word that time. Y'all know how we mess up.
I don't even
want nobody to see how I put that sentence together that time. Amen. I don't want to have to look at the sin that I have committed. He goes on. He don't want to see it himself. Amen. And he does admit. He says that my sin. He said, I acknowledge my transgression. Verse 3, and my sin is ever before me. It's right there in my face. Our sins are right there in our faces. We ain't forgot what we did. Just like David ain't forgot. And many of us are still hoping nobody finds out about some of the mess we did. How we really strayed from the Lord. Amen. So David asked God to erase my sins. Oh, look at this prayer. Amen. Now this prayer, amen, this is David's prayer. But it can easily be Audrey's prayer. It can easily be Anthony's prayer. It can be your prayer. If you are sincere about getting rid of the sin in your life. If you're sincere about drawing nearer to God. If you are sincerely sorry for the sin that you have, this can be your prayer. Amen. And it ought to be your prayer.
Amen.
It ought to be your prayer. If you really want God to hear your prayer and your cry, this is a model prayer of a repentant heart. Amen. We're talking about the awakened sinner. Amen. David prays this prayer after the confrontation with Nathan. After his sins stand before him. Amen. After. Amen. This prayer is for the pardon of great sins. Hell deserving sins. On account of tender mercy. Amen. We deserve hell. But we are crying out for tender mercy. Amen. Because we sinned. Not just against man, but we sin against God. And we have to acknowledge it.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Admit it. Elijah did. We must understand that we who have sinned are human. We are human. David makes that clear in the word. Amen. We are human, but he who pardons is divine. Our great God, who has no bounds, can forgive all of the sins that we have committed in our lives. Amen. All we need to do is call on Jesus. That's what Romans 10:9 says. Believe. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, acknowledge, and believe in thine heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Now Jesus died, amen, for the sins of the whole world. He died, amen, so that we could have everlasting life. Everlasting life, amen. He died for the sins of the whole world. So all we need to do is go to God. So David cries out to God, and he asks God to wash me through it. Through it. See, this washing got to be thorough. Thorough. I don't know about you, but I have washed some things. Amen. And looked and know I had to wash it again. Because it didn't come out. Like I did, I had to wash it again. Amen. And everything God forgives, that's what God will do for us. By this sin in our lives. If he got to wash us again, he'll wash us by the word. Amen. But you got to want to be clean. You got to want to be clean. Individually, you have to want to be clean. David wanted to be clean. Amen. Thank you, God. He wanted to be clean. Look at him. He cries out to God. He says, multiply to wash me. Just whatever it takes. Just wash me, God, over and over and over again. He says, how long I have lain in this sin? A mighty long time. See, some sin, some stains, amen, you can hit it one time, amen, and it's gone. But some stains, when you let them sit there, when you let them sit there, and then and add more to it, it takes more washing to get some of that stain out, amen? And some of us been lost in sin a long time, amen? We might as well admit it, because it's the truth. Born into sin, shaping into iniquity. Now, we didn't have nothing to do with our birth. Nothing to do with our conception. We had nothing to do with that. Born into sin, shaping into iniquity. Practice the practicing of sin. Amen. But God, who fixed it a long time ago, amen, says that we don't have to stay there. Amen. Jesus died so that we don't have to stay there. So David, right now, based on the confrontation and based on the fact that he's looking his sins dead in the eye. He is acknowledging who he sinned against. He is acknowledging how filthy he is and how deep in sin he was. Amen. And he cries out to God to wash me. Do you want to be washed? Do you want to be washed? Do you want the stain out? Ooh, David said, I don't even want a trace of my defilement left.
Amen.
I don't want sin no more. I want it so clean that you can't even tell where the stain was. That's what the believer desires. A true believer, amen? A truly awakened sinner. Don't even want to be able to recognize where the stain was. Amen. God is so good. And God can do just that.
Yes, again.
Amen. That's an awakened, a truly awakened conscience. See, Deacon Carson, he used to pray in his prayer. He would always pray, amen, for the careless and the unconcerned. The careless and the unconcerned. See, there are still some careless souls who are content with normal cleansing.
They're clean enough. But the truly awakened servant, amen, wants to be clean. Like they are potash washed. They want to be clean. Amen. Oh, I remember Big Mama did some washing. When she washed, she washed. Amen. That's what we want God to do. We don't want the sin, the stain of sin left on us. We want to be free and free indeed. So David is asking God, whatever it takes, Lord, whatever it takes, do it. He says, and cleanse me from my sins. Amen. Cleanse me by any means necessary. Cleanse me from my sins. I don't want to be left with the guilt of sin.
That's right.
The guilt. You ever felt guilty?
Yes.
Guilt will whoop you up.
Yes,
guilt will paralyze you. Guilt will keep you from lifting any hymn. I don't care how many you have lifted before. Guilt will keep you out of church. Keep you from worship. Amen. Because you find yourself just tore up and you know you tore up. And it's a place that we ought not be. That's why we have to be mindful that any of us can fall.
That's right.
Any of us can fall. But God is right there, amen, to pick us up. Thank you, God.
Amen.
Thank you, God. We want to be so clean that there's no guilt left. Notice, it's not the punishment that David cries out against. Amen. He's not crying out against the judgment that Nathan told him would come upon him. Notice, David is crying out against the sin. A thief, typically, a thief is not worried about, he loves what he's stealing now. And the only thing he's really worried about is going to prison. He ain't worried about getting caught by you and nobody else, but going to prison, they got a problem with that. The murderer will murder and murder and murder over. They ain't worried about death row. They just worried about killing and killing and more killing. Amen. But you, the consequences, sometimes now they don't like the electric chair. When that come up, that will cause a murderer to at least think about the consequences. It don't necessarily stop them from what they're getting ready to do, amen, but they think about it. And so David, at this point, David is sick of his sin. He's sick of his sin.
All right.
Now, when are you going to be sick of your sin? When are you going to be sick of your sin? See, we know, I know you're sick of wearing the mask. I know you're sick of the folk on your job. I know you're sick about the folk at the White House. I know you're sick about all of that. You're sick and tired of it. But when are you going to be sick and tired of your sin? Because God got that other stuff. God got that. When are you going to be sick of your sin? Sick enough to cry out to God. That's an awakened sinner. Awaken. The kids say woke. Woke. Woke means you are now aware of what's going on.
That's right.
You're aware of the truth of the matter. You woke. That's what the young people say. When you gonna wake up? Wake up to the reality, amen, that there is a heaven and a hell.
That's right.
Wake up to the reality that the word is truth. Wake up to the reality that God is sovereign and he sees all and he knows all. That's what David said. David said, against thee and thee only have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight. You saw me and you see me. God has an all-seeing eye.
Yes, he do.
Amen. All sin. sin. God will deal gently with us.
Yes, he will.
Why? Because we are humbly acknowledging now, amen, that we have sinned against the Almighty God. Against thee. And thee only have I sinned. Oh, Jesus. All of his wrongdoing. Centered, culminated, and came to a climax at the foot of the divine throne. All of our wrongdoing, we got to answer for. Amen. We got to come clean. Amen. To injure our fellow men is sin. That's what David did with Uriah. That's what he did with Bathsheba. He hurt Bathsheba just as much as he hurt Uriah. Amen. To injure our fellow men is sin. To mess over people is sin. Because in so doing, we violate the law of God. He did that when he went into Bathsheba. He violated the law of God. Anything that we do contrary to the word of God is a violation of the law of God. We have committed treason. We have become traitors. Traitors. Amen. In the very court of the Lord. Why? Because he sees it. The earth is the Lord's, the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein belongs to God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We boldly committed our sin. Just as sure as we are aware of the presence of God and we sin with a boldness, with a shamelessness about ourselves. But David cries out to God. Amen. I've cried out to God many times and I still cry out to God because I need it every day. Amen. Every day, every minute, every second, every hour, I need the God. I need our God. David said that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest and be clear when thou judgest. See, again, David recognized that what he did right in the face of God. And so he really does not have a leg to stand on. God saw me do what I did. He heard me say what I said. And he is going to judge my sin. We don't have a leg to stand on. All we can do is throw ourselves on the mercy of God. Amen?
Amen.
On the mercies of God. Our God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. He is a forgiving God.
Yes, he is.
Amen. Thank you, God. He is a forgiving God. Again, David says, I was shaping. Behold, look. I was shaping in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Now, he is not making excuses here. He is just coming face to face with the truth of the matter. Okay? In sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts and in the hidden part, thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Amen. The more I call on you, God, the more you make me aware of the wretch that I am. See, because I am inferior and you are superior. I am imperfect and you are perfect. I am unholy and thou art holy in all of your ways. Oh God, I need your shaping. See, I've been shaping myself by the world standard. Shaping in iniquity. But God, I cry out to you, amen. I cry out to you. I need you to cleanse me. I need you to restore me. And then, God, I need you to use me. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Cleanse me, restore me, and use me. That's David's ultimate cry to God. Amen. In this psalm, amen, he is confessing. God. He comes humbly. He is admitting. See, confessing is more than just admitting. You got to admit. But in admitting your sin, you got to then also agree with what God says about the sin. Some people admit, they'll make a confession, but they don't agree with it. We agree to disagree. We know how to fix it up down here. We won't ever, we might say, well, yeah, what I did was wrong, but still, we don't acknowledge that we have gone against the word of God. We got to have a godly perspective. We got to start seeing things as God sees it. That's why we need the presence of the Holy Spirit. Amen. He is going to reveal the truth of the matter to us according to the word of God. So we can't just admit our sins, but we also have to agree with God about our sins. Ooh, amen. Got to do something. Amen. Got to do more than just admit. Just admit it. What is that going to do? What does that do just because you admitted it? If there's no change. What good does it do? Amen. James said to look in the mirror. Amen. To see the sin, to see the problem, and then walk away. Don't do nothing about what you saw. That's a problem. Amen. Oh, that's why we got to be more than hearers of the word. Yeah. We also have to be doers of the word of God. Thank you, God. So David, thank you, God. David is now an awakened sinner. Amen. He's woke. He's woke to the sin that's in his life. So he cries out to God. He says, purge me with hyssop. Amen. And I shall be clean. See, hyssop, you can read about hyssop over in Leviticus. Amen. You can read about hyssop where it was used as a cleansing, for ceremonial cleansing. Amen. Hyssop would get the stain out. Amen. It's how you prepare to go before God. Amen. To go before the throne. Amen. Purge me with hyssop. And so David wants to be clean, and he understands that hyssop was used for ceremonial cleansing. And I tell you, all of us need a ceremonial cleansing.
We do.
We need a ceremonial cleansing. We need to go through the whole process of being cleansed, falling prostrate on our knees and opening our hearts to God, admitting and confessing our sins, amen, and turning ourselves over to God.
Yeah.
Amen. A ceremonial cleansing. Purge me with hyssop. Amen. And then Jesus, when he was giving his life, amen, when he was giving up his life, laying down his life for us, and they gave him that sponge with the vinegar, they used a branch, a hyssop branch, to extend that. Amen. That sponge to Jesus. Amen. We need a cleaning. And what Jesus, in Jesus' death, he died for our cleansing. He died that we may be cleansed from sin. He died, y'all. He died, and he was buried. But that third day morning, he got up. He got up with all power in his hand. So David says, purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. That's faith right there. That's faith. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Amen. Make me to hear joy and gladness. See, right now, all I'm hearing is what the world has to say. Right now, what I'm hearing now does not feed my soul, does not comfort my soul. So in this cleansing process, Lord, help me, oh God, to hear joy and gladness again, because your hearing of joy and gladness is dull when you are covered in sin. That's why you're looking at other folk trying to figure out why they got so much praise for the Lord. our joy and our gladness. He prays about the sorrow that he has been feeling because of his sin. Amen. If you can sin and it don't bother you, something wrong. Something is very wrong. So David cries out to God. Amen. Hide. He said that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. Amen. He was like a poor wretch whose bones are crushed. Crushed by no ordinary means, but crushed because God is working on him. God has extended judgment because of David's sin. And he's going to deal with us in that same way. So now David is requesting a great thing from God because he seeks joy. Though his heart is sinful, he seeks the joy of the Lord. He was playing the harp. But at some point, he put it down. Sin will have you not praising God like you used to praise God. That's why the Bible says return to your first love. We got to go back to the altar, fall down on our knees, amen, and ask God to forgive us of our sins. Look at David. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. David asked God to create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. Now, it's right that he would ask God to create in him a clean heart because God is the creator, you know. He is the creator. And so in this request, David is simply asking for forgiveness. He acknowledged his sin. Now he asks God, the creator, to forgive him. Amen. Forgive me, Lord. He knew the inner person, his heart, and the source of his trouble. And so he asked God to create in him a clean heart, knowing that only God can perform this miracle. Only God can do that.
Yeah.
Can't nobody else give you a clean heart but God. But God. He is the heart specialist.
Yeah.
He specializes. And so God can change our hearts.
Yes, he can.
Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Listen to what the word says. Jeremiah 24:7. God says, and I will give them an heart to know me, that I am the Lord. And they shall be my people. And I will be their God, for they shall return unto me with their whole heart. Whole heart. Don't we owe God our whole heart?
Yeah.
We ought not be half-hearted when it comes to God. Yeah. We ought to give God our whole heart. Ezekiel 11:19, and I will give them one heart, and I will put a new spirit within you, and I will take the stony heart out of their flesh and will give them an heart of flesh.
Yeah.
Amen. We ought to have a heart for man.
Not
a heart for man. Not just for ourselves. Not a selfish heart, but a giving heart.
Yeah.
Why I gotta have a tough heart? Why I can't feel with a tough heart. I can't be empathetic. I can't show compassion. And we have to extend that same compassion that God extends unto us.
That's right.
Amen. So he'll give us a heart of flesh. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Then he says over in Ezekiel 36:25, then will I sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your filthiness, from all of your idols will I clean you. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you, and I will again take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh.
Yeah.
Verse 27, and I will put my spirit within you, and cause you to walk in my statutes, has a new walk and a new talk. Amen. An awakened sinner does not wake up to sin, but wakes up to please God the Father. Cast me not away from thy presence, Lord God. Amen. Don't throw me away as worthless, God. But receive me, God. Don't banish me like Cain, Lord God. You know, Cain was banished because he killed his brother. And his blood spoke. Amen. His blood spoke to God. And we are asking God, David is asking God that his Holy Spirit not be removed from him. Don't take your Holy Spirit from me, God. Oh, if you've ever had the presence of the Holy Spirit, and you have, if you have confessed Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you don't want God to take his Holy Spirit from you. Our help, our comforter, our convictor, our teacher. You don't want God to take his Holy Spirit, the very presence of God living in us. Ooh. You don't want him to take it.
No.
Paul uses Psalm 32 as an example of salvation apart from works. David was forgiven not because of any works he did to earn forgiveness, but simply because he asked in faith.
Yeah.
Because of the sacrifice of Christ, any sinner can ask God for forgiveness. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Because of what Jesus did, any sinner can ask God for forgiveness, and that is for a clean heart.
Yeah.
And he will, she will receive it. The Apostle John also tells us, if we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sin, that's what 1 John 1 and 9 says. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Thank you, God. In spite of all that David did, and in spite of all that we do, God is willing to forgive because Jesus paid the penalty that we deserve. He died in our stead. Every stripe he took was ours. Jesus died in our stead. No matter how dirty we are, God can create in us a clean heart.
Yes, he can.
Yes, he can. Amen. If you believe it, by faith you shall receive it. Amen. We thank God for his marvelous salvation work. Thank you, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. When David pleads with God to restore to me the joy of your salvation, he is asking that he would again have fellowship with God, and that the same fellowship that he once knew and enjoyed. David could not enjoy God's fellowship while he had unconfessed sin. And we cannot enjoy God's fellowship while we have unconfessed sin. When David pleads again with God, he acknowledges, amen, that God is the one to forgive him. Even today, my brothers and sisters, we can lose the joy of our salvation.
Amen.
We will not lose salvation. We cannot lose our salvation, but we can lose the joy of our salvation. We cannot lose our salvation. Amen. Sin. Amen. The Bible says, as we go over to Romans and Romans 8, thank you, Holy Spirit. Romans 8, we are reminded of what the word says. Amen. That nothing, as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love Christ Jesus, our Lord. We cannot lose our salvation. But sin can rob us of our joy and the enjoyment of close fellowship with our God. Take not, David says, thy Holy Spirit from me. Take not, O God, restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways, and sinners shall be converted unto thee. Then, Lord God, now that you have forgiven me, now that you have restored me, Lord God, now, oh God, I am useful to the kingdom. Mm-hmm. Covenant sin, unrepentant sin, I'm not useful to the kingdom. But now I am useful to the kingdom. Use me, God, to tell somebody about your goodness, how you brought me, oh God. Now, God, now that I am an awakened sinner, God, I'm woke now. I'm woke now to your truth, amen. I'm woke. We got to wake up again to the reality that there is a real call on our lives and that it is bigger than we are. We got to wake up and then we got to get up. We got to get up and be about the Father's business. David said, then will I teach transgressors thy way. Amen. Mm-hmm. Now, oh God, my life is a living testimony. Mm-hmm. Amen. I can tell others. I'm going to reach out to others who are covered in sin. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to tell them that salvation is available.
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Yes, Lord.
And if he saved me, he can surely save you. And if he has to reach way down, Jesus will pick you up. Amen. Paul said, I was chief sinner. I was the chief sinner. Amen. And a lot of us were chief sinners. We were chief out there in the world. Amen. But now we know, now that we have come to God in humility, now that we have come to God acknowledging, now that we have been awakened, now that we are woke to our sinful condition and have been forgiven, we have a duty to tell others that Jesus saves. And he saves to the utmost. Amen. It is not our duty to seek the conversion of others until we have been converted. If you have not been converted, you cannot seek the conversion of others. We must be converted. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We must be converted. So we thank God. Amen. That we have been awakened. We are saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. Now we are in position to be used by God as we confess our sins every day and throughout the day, because there are sins that we commit that we don't even know about. But we want to, amen, be used by God, and the only way we can do that is with a clean heart and clean hands and a clean mind and a clean walk and a clean talk. We cannot look like the world. We must look like our Father, which is in heaven. So now, oh God, we thank God for this awakened sinner, this new man in Christ Jesus. And as we close, we share with you 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Amen. You can get up now. You can serve God now. Amen. And all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself by Christ Jesus, and have given us, watch this, given to us the ministry of reconciliation. We have been given that ministry to seek to save those that are lost. Yeah. We have been assigned to the ministry of reconciliation because we have now been reconciled back to God. To wit, that God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself, not imputing their trespasses unto committed unto us the word of reconciliation. Now, as David said, then I can teach. Mm-hmm. Verse 20 of 2 Corinthians 5 says, now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. Mm-hmm. God has cleaned us up. He's picked us up. He's turned us around. Mm-hmm. Amen. He's placed our feet on solid ground. Mm-hmm. Amen. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. Mm-hmm. As though God did beseech you by us, we pray you in Christ's stead. Be ye reconciled to God, for he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. We have been called to righteousness, and we are to seek to save those that are lost, that they may be called to righteousness as well. We are talking about the awakened sinner. God did whatever it took that we might be saved, in that he gave his son. We must now do whatever it takes, amen, to seek to save those that are lost. Mm-hmm. We got to come out of our comfort zone, and we got to tell the world that Jesus lives, amen.
Amen.
David said, then, after I'm cleansed, after I'm restored, then will I teach transgressors thy ways. Amen. That's how I'm going to do it. He resolves to display the same love that God displayed unto him. And then sinners will be converted unto God. Mm. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's what it's about.
Amen.
The conversion of sinners. The mission is still the same, to seek to save those that are lost. We need everybody to be awakened, amen, to the goodness of God, in that he gave his only begotten son, Jesus, as, amen, the sacrifice, the perfect sacrifice, that we might be reconciled back to God. Jesus came in the flesh. He died. Amen. He was buried. God raised him that third day morning with all power. He ascended back to heaven. Amen. He is now seated at the right hand of God the Father. But one day, he's coming back again.
Yes.
And when he comes again, he's coming as the righteous judge.
Yes.
Who shall be able to stand? Mm-hmm. Who shall? Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, let us be about the Father's business. Amen. Heavenly Father, God, we thank you.
Thank you,
O God, that we too are awakened, O God, to your goodness. We thank you, God, for changing our names, oh God, from sinner to saint, oh God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, oh God, for saving our souls from a burning hell. Thank you, God, that one day we will be with you in paradise, oh God, in that great land where there will be no more crying, no more dying, no more sickness, Lord God. Oh God, but we will just praise you forevermore, oh God. Holy, holy, holy unto the Lamb of God, who took away the sin, who takes away the sin of the world. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for this blessed opportunity to hear from heaven, oh God. We pray that some heart was convicted, oh God, just as David's heart was, just as our hearts have been, oh God. We pray, oh God, that this Christian would stand boldly, Lord God, and speak when you tell us to speak, oh God, and confront sin wherever it may be, Lord God, because sin is that thing, oh God, that will land us in hell, oh God. Sin is that thing, oh God, that is detrimental to the family, Lord God. Sin is that thing, oh God, that will destroy the heart of man, oh God. And so we need, oh God, believers to stand up boldly in the name of Jesus, oh God, seeking to save those that are lost. We just bless your name, God. We thank you, God. We love you. We give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. We pray, oh God, for those who have accepted Jesus as their personal Savior. And we pray, oh God, for those who have not yet come, but are soon to come, confessing Jesus as Lord of their lives. We just bless your name, God. In the Master's name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, God. Amen. Amen. Thank you, God. Amen. 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 Thank you, God. Mm-hmm.